Joining us now to review some of the headlines of today's newspapers from around the world is our Rise News analyst, Emmanuel Efeni. Great Malabite.
Good morning,
you had a great weekend.
Yes, I did. Good morning, Rufai.
Good morning,
Ayo.
Good morning.
Yes, we start the review with this day in Nigeria's newspaper of record. The lead story, Afenifere to Tinubu seek $13 billion debt forgiveness from creditors to stabilize economy. Advises president to cut cost of governance. Halt hike in federal government tertiary institutions, school tuition fees. Fitch, Nigeria's inflation to average 25.1% in 2023 as poverty rate spikes. Says real GDP growth to slow to 2.7% on high living costs. Growth expected to decelerate modestly to 3.2% in 2024. Forecast Dangote refinery to begin operations, bring relief by quarter four of 2023. I'm sure we cannot wait for the Dangote refinery to start flowing out. PMS, perhaps there will be a change in pricing if we are not importing. We are not subject to the vagaries of the exchange rate and, of course, what happens in the international market. Now, Afenifere, the pan-Yoruba social-political group, giving the president, President Bola Tinubu, a list of to-do if he wants to improve this economy. Reduction in emoluments, slash the size of government, halt the hike in tuition fees, and, of course, seek debt relief. I don't know which creditors will be ready to give us debt relief at this time, but there's no harm in trying. A country that spends 95% plus of its revenue to service debt cannot make good progress. So, word of advice there from Afenifere, the pan-Yoruba social-political group. Yes, Pat Debanjo insists it's social-political, not social-cultural. According to Pa Adebanjo, because Afenifere, in his words, is a political party in its own right. Now, let's look at the story above the masthead. Atiku, heavens won't fall if tribunal removes Tinubu, says that presidential election has never been nullified before, not good enough reason to avoid the right thing. XVP is. INEC admitted on record, Atiku 121 states, in February polls. Yes, can these politicians just allow the tribunal to do their job? And of course, that story is also being reported in the Daily Sun newspaper. Presidential election anxiety grips Tinubu. Atiku Obi, as Judgment Day beckons, declare me winner with INEC submission. Atiku petitioners to go for adoption of addresses. Yes, the other day it was the APC that was saying, oh, there will be anarchy if the tribunal were to rule that the president did not win the election. Let the tribunal do its job. Politicians should not put undue pressure. Make your submission, prove your case, and let the tribunal give the ruling. And we are all waiting to hear the outcome. And we know it will go all the way to the Supreme Court. Now, the Guardian newspaper, 105 days of sit at home. Southeast loses 7.6 trillion naira productivity investment to agitation in 2 years. Well, the governors are making effort. The governor of Enugu State has warned, if you don't come and open your business on a Monday, then ready for the consequence. But we hope security is in place to protect those who venture to defy this so-called sit-at-home order, because the last time we saw people being attacked on the streets, not good optics to encourage anybody to dare. But if there is security, of course, people will come out. They want to do their business, legitimate business, that is. Now, the Nigerian Tribune newspaper, NSARS, Lagos plans burial for 103 bodies. Government says victims not from Lekki toll gate. Where? 103 Nigerians to be given mass burial after more than 2 years. Nobody could identify them. This is not how a country treats its citizens. We cannot identify those who died, 103 of them, whether they were picked at Lekki toll gates or anywhere for that matter. It is not good enough. What effort was made by the government in Lagos State to ensure that people come and identify their loved ones? 103 Nigerians who died cannot be identified in Lagos. Where did they come from? Are they strangers? No, these are Nigerians. That is not good enough. I will leave it at that and move on. The Punch newspaper, workers kick as governors borrowed 2.2 trillion naira from banks. Governors borrowing spree has left states poorer. Pensioners, workers lament. Government must avoid short-term borrowing that may harm states' finances. Don't warn. Now, the Daily Trust newspaper, concerns mount over Tinubu's directive on grains. Strategic reserves drop to 150,000 tons. Sources, 24.8 million Nigerians risk acute hunger. World Food Program, FAO, reports. CBN releases grain sales. Distribution begins today. 5,000 trucks needed. Now, well, but the Abuja Inquirer is reporting that as hardship deepens, FCTA unveils food subsidy. That's the Abuja Inquirer. Yes, to subsidize grains and fertilizer. Yes, the FCTA is to commence sales of subsidized grains and fertilizer to residents of the Federal Capital Territory. Now, if we look at the Daily Telegraph newspaper, fuel, Nigeria, orders face more pump price increase as IEF says crude price will rise in quarter two. Nation will collapse if nothing is done to arrest trend. Analysts are saying NLC's proposed 200,000 naira minimum wage not sustainable. LCCI, federal government can save over $200 billion yearly by blocking loopholes. Now, the Daily Independent reporting, Daily Independent dollar shortage widens official black market rate gaps. Of course, CBN, willing buyer, willing seller plan has failed. Well, scarcity, there has to be enough. But CBN is no longer in the business of saving the Naira, defending the Naira. So the Naira has been floated, it's floating, Rufai. I know you have your views on that.
Experiment, but, I called it. And no. You can see I've been proven correctly. When I said experiment, I was referring to how we did an experiment with SFEM, second tier foreign exchange market in 1986. You can see the experiments going on. I want to talk about the answers debacle too, but I hear no time. Please just finish up.
Okay, just take one foreign newspaper, the Guardian newspaper of UK. Thousands forced to flee roads, fire nightmare. Of course, tourists who have gone to Greece having a hard time being evacuated because of the wildfire being facilitated by high wind in that country. Ruben, Rufai, Ayo.
Well, no time, but that's just a reminder of the effect of climate change. Temperatures in southern Europe have been in excess of 40 degrees, you know, and this is the effect you've seen in Greece, Rhode Island, where there have been fires, and also in other parts where you could just, you could boil a pot of rice, just putting it outside there under the, heat. But thank you very much, Emmanuel Ofeni. We'll see you tomorrow.